Hello everyone. Today I just bought a new tool. I believe it will help me repair electrical devices quickly and accurately. This is not a multimeter. It is a specialized tool for measuring battery internal resistance. It helps us easily assess the quality of any battery. Inside the bag, we have an IR502 battery internal resistance tester, a set of four-wire test probes, a battery charging cable, and a user manual. First, I will disassemble it to see what's inside. It has a 1200 mAh battery here. According to the manufacturer, it can work continuously for 10 hours. Inside is a double-layer printed circuit board, densely packed with SMD components. Unfortunately, the manufacturer has removed the names of all the components, probably for security reasons, but it's not a problem as long as it works well. On the top, we have a 9-pin socket for the test clamp. There is also a charging port and a small LED light to help us work easily in low-light environments. On the front, we have four buttons. This is the power button. We hold it for a few seconds to turn on the device and press it quickly to select modes and access settings. We can set the battery internal resistance threshold. This way, we can quickly sort batteries by their internal resistance value. Additionally, we can change the device's language. There are only two languages available, English and Chinese. The next two buttons are navigation buttons. Additionally, we can use them to turn the LED light and the screen backlight on or off. The last button is for toggling the sound and calibrating to zero, which helps improve measurement accuracy. Now I will connect the test clamp and test the main function of the device, which is checking battery internal resistance. I will test a 12-volt 20-amp-hour battery. We can easily check both the voltage and the internal resistance of this battery. I have compared the results with the data sheet and concluded that this battery is in excellent condition. Next are two lithium batteries in parallel. The results also show that they are in very good condition. If you think this device can only check battery internal resistance, you're mistaken. In the next part, I'll show you the fantastic features that this device offers. Firstly, you can use it to measure shunt resistors or other resistors with small values. If you use a multimeter, you may not be able to measure values that are too small. But with the IR502, everything is straightforward. This is a 25 milliohm shunt resistor, and the result is very accurate. Because a shunt resistor is a component used to measure current, even a small error can lead to inaccurate measurements. With the IR502 meter, we can check the shunt resistor before installation and ensure its accuracy. Next, we can check the equivalent series resistance ESR of capacitors. With a regular multimeter, it's very difficult to test ESR. But with the IR502, we can easily measure the ESR of capacitors with remarkable accuracy. I often use old MOSFETs for my projects. They are much cheaper than buying new MOSFETs and less likely to be counterfeit compared to new ones on the market. However, the downside is that the quality of MOSFETs can degrade over time. With the IR502 internal resistance tester, I can check one of the most important parameters of a MOSFET, which is RDS on. To check this parameter, we apply a 10-volt voltage to the gate and measure the resistance between the drain and source pins. With the 80NF70 MOSFET, I measured the RDS on to be 7.8 milliohms. This MOSFET is still of very good quality. With the HY3506 MOSFET, the measured RDS on is only 3 milliohmians. Compared to the 3.5 milliohms specified in the datasheet, this MOSFET is of perfect quality. This is my new project. I will use a toroidal transformer to replace the conventional transformer in DC-DC conversion circuits. I will need to test the efficiency and evaluate the performance between the conventional EI transformer and the toroidal transformer. To do this, I will connect a small resistor in series with the output of the circuit. Here, I am using a 0.22 ohm resistor. Next, I will measure the resistance as well as the voltage drop across this resistor and apply Ohm's law to accurately determine the current value. I measured the voltage drop across the resistor as 0.336 volts, which calculates to a current of 1.44 atts flowing through it. Consequently, we can easily calculate the output power as 404 watts. With an input power of 422 watts, we achieve an efficiency of 95.9%. This is a remarkably high value for a DC-DC converter. My project has been successful. After using the IR502 for a day, I found it to be a very accurate battery internal resistance tester with long battery life and ease of use. you should consider buying one for your work. Its price is also very affordable.